Hello students, I am Mrs. Anjali Nadgoda, KLS Gupte PU College of Commerce and Science, Belagavi. In continuation with unit number 10, that is the S block elements, this is video number 2, and in last video, that is in first video, we have seen up to the physical properties of S block elements, and today we are going to learn chemical properties. Let me explain you why they are showing, why they are very reactive. In last video, we have already seen that these S block elements, that is group 1 and group 2 elements, they are very, very reactive, and hence they occur in always in compound form or in molecular form. They do not occur in free state. That's it. Now, why they are very reactive? Because of their low value of first ionization enthalpy, then large size compared to the period elements. Remember, compared to the that period, particular period elements, okay, and low heat of atomization means the energy required to separate the atoms is called as heat of atomization, and that is very low, and hence they are very, very reactive. This reactivity increases down the group. Okay, so let us see one by one. Reaction with air, that is with oxygen. Now, even sometimes in air nitrogen is considered, and this we will see one exception also. Okay, usually the alkali metals, when they kept open in air, they become tarnish, means become rusted, get rusted. Okay, or a brownish layer is formed on the surface. This is due to the formation of an oxide. Okay, and even this oxide layer, when it comes in contact with moisture from air, it forms hydroxide on the surface. So how this alkali metals, they react? When they are burnt in air, they form different kinds of oxides. Okay, now the reaction with air, it may be in limited supply or it may be in excess of air. Okay, so alkali metals on reaction with limited quantity of oxygen, that is limited supply of air, form normal oxides, that is M2O. So where M is lithium to cesium. Okay, and you can write the reaction for any metal here. So this is when limited supply of air is there. Now what happens in excess of air? In excess of air, every element is showing different oxide, okay, or giving different oxide. It may be monoxide, it may be peroxide or peroxide or superoxide also. Okay, so lithium gives lithium monoxide, sodium gives sodium peroxide, that is Na2O2, at 575 Kelvin temperature, and remaining other elements, that is from sodium, that is from potassium to cesium, they all form superoxides. Okay, so the common reaction is given, M plus O2 gives MO2. Here the oxidation state of oxygen changes, whereas alkali metals remains same, and oxidation state of all the alkali metals is always +1. Okay, now this reactivity already we have seen that increases down the group due to stability of peroxides and superoxides. Okay, then lithium shows exceptional property. This already I told you that there is one element which is reacting directly with nitrogen from air and forms nitride, and this reaction is shown only by lithium, whereas other elements, that is from sodium to cesium, they do not react directly with nitrogen when they are open, when they are reacted with air. Okay, as they are highly reactive, as these alkali metals, they are highly reactive towards air and water or moisture, they are always kept in kerosene. Okay, Now this question can be asked, that is, why alkali metals are stored in kerosene oil? So answer is because of their high reactivity towards water and air. Okay. Now we'll see the second reaction, that is reaction with hydrogen. When alkali metals, they react with dry hydrogen, remember this requires heat. Okay, so the temperature is different for different elements, and if we see in this case, lithium requires very high temperature. Now this is because of its small size, okay, and high ionization enthalpy. This is an exceptional behavior of lithium. Otherwise, remaining all other elements, they usually react at 673 Kelvin. Okay, what it forms? They form colorless crystalline hydrides. They form crystalline hydrides. Now these are ionic compounds, okay, or ionic solids, and they are having high melting point. The third reaction is reaction with water. As already I have told you that when they are highly reactive and when they react with water, they form hydroxides, respective hydroxides, that is respective alkali, and hence they are called as alkali metals. So while forming hydroxides or alkali, they liberate hydrogen gas. Okay, this is the common reaction, and here the reaction is shown. 2m plus H2O gives 2MOH plus H2. Again, these alkalis are strong alkali and they are ionic in nature. Okay, means in solution form they dissociate as a positive ion and negative ion, that is cation and anion. So here one example is shown of Na. When sodium metal is added to water, remember very nicely the reaction takes place, very vigorous reaction takes place, and sodium dances on the surface with giving hissing sound, that is of liberation of hydrogen, and finally it forms sodium hydroxide, which we can test with phenolphthalein indicator. So when we put one drop of phenolphthalein indicator in this solution, it becomes pink color, and from that we can identify that sodium hydroxide is formed. Okay, as we move down in the group, this reaction becomes very very violent, means very very vigorous, and it does not require any heat. Okay, so in that only lithium reacts gently, whereas other elements, they react very strongly. Potassium melts and always catches fire. Sometimes even when this hydroxide is formed, it catches fire, and this is shown by the magician usually. By adding the piece of these elements, they are showing it as water catches fire. Okay. Alkali metals are known to have large negative reduction potential values, that is ERP values. As a result, they can act as better reducing agent as compared to hydrogen. Usually we take hydrogen as a good reducing agent. Even alkali metals are good reducing agent than hydrogen, because they are having the capacity, or they are having the tendency to lose the electron very easily. Let us see the reaction with halogens. So this is fifth reaction. Alkali metals react vigorously with halogens to form metal halides. For example, sodium when reacts with chlorine gas, it forms sodium chloride, which we use as a table salt, okay, or normal salt. So all these are salts and they are ionic in nature, but lithium compounds, they are covalent in nature, again due to its small size. Okay, Usually these metal halides, they are ionic crystalline solids. Okay, so the general equation is given, 2m plus x2 gives 2mx, where m is from lithium to cesium, where x is fluorine, chlorine, bromine or iodine. Now when we see the reactivity for alkali metals, suppose if we have taken sodium as alkali metal, then with particular halogen, these alkali metals, means if we change the alkali metals with any one halogen, for example if we take Cl, then the reaction or the reactivity increases from lithium to cesium, means cesium is highly reactive whereas lithium is slowly reacting. Okay, now when we take with halogens, means by keeping the metal constant and halogens when we change, then the reactivity decreases from fluorine to iodine, means fluorine is highly reactive compared to iodine. So we can write this reactivity order like this: F2, then Cl2, then Br2 and then I2. Okay, let us see one exception. Lithium halides are somewhat covalent. What we have seen in earlier slide is the halides, metal halides which are formed after the reaction with halogens, they are ionic crystalline solid, but lithium forms covalent compound. Again, due to its small size and high tendency to distort electron cloud around the negative halide ion. Now what is this is called as polarization capacity or polarization capability. What is mean by polarization? Polarization is nothing but attraction of the electron cloud towards itself. So as lithium is having very small size, lithium always tries to attract the electron cloud of chloride ion, because chloride ion is having large size and hence this the size of the chloride ion get changed, what we call it as distorted, and this is called as polarization. Okay, so the distortion of electron cloud of the anion, means here we can take it as example of Cl minus by the cation, that is by lithium ion, is called as polarization. Now in this, since anion is with very large size can be easily distorted, among halides lithium iodide is the most covalent in nature, because iodide ion is having again very large size compared to all the halogens. Then let me explain you reducing nature. As already I told you that these alkali metals, they are having tendency to lose the electron, the last electron or the outermost electron. Why? Because by losing that electron, they become very stable as that of nearest noble gas, and hence they are strongest reducing agent. Okay, so in this, if we see from in the group, first group, lithium is the strongest reducing agent, whereas sodium is the least powerful reducing agent. But after sodium, again the reducing character increases. So this is little bit change in lithium and sodium, because lithium shows the exceptional behavior again due to its small size and large heat of hydration. And the last reaction, that is solution in liquid ammonia, means how they react with ammonia, liquid ammonia. These alkali metals, they dissolve in liquid ammonia giving deep blue solutions which are conducting in nature. Conducting means they are good conductors of electricity, means if we pass the if we add the electrodes and if we attach to it to battery, then they are showing the conductance. Okay, now why it happens? Because
So these metals reacts with some amount of some molecules of ammonia, forming ammoniated metal as well as ammoniated electron. This free electron is responsible for the flow of current. Okay, and the color of the solution is because of what? The ammoniated metal ion. Okay, now ammonia here acts as a ligand which gives the pair of electron from itself to the metal, and hence in presence of ammonia, this gives the electron absorbs the energy that is from red region or the visible region, and it gets excited. While coming back to the original position, it emits light which is blue color, because when red color is absorbed, the transmitted color is blue color, and hence the whole solution becomes deep blue color. Okay, now this reaction especially takes place because of presence of ammonia, which acts as a ligand. Okay, now when that electron absorbs the energy, it becomes excited, and excited state is always unstable, and hence it comes back to the original position. Okay, which imparts blue color solution. Now what happens, what is one more property? The solutions are paramagnetic in nature, means they are attracted towards the magnetic field. The solution is attracted towards the magnetic field, but when we keep it, when the solution is kept as it is on standing, slowly hydrogen gas is liberated, forming amide, means metal ammoniated solution becomes amide, MnH2, okay, and liberates hydrogen gas, and therefore the solution color changes to bronze color, little bit reddish brown color, and it becomes diamagnetic, means it does not get attracted or it is repelled by the magnetic field due to loss of electrons or due to absence of free electron or ammoniated electron. Okay, so this is how the properties, chemical properties, we have completed of group 1, and in this topic, in this part, uses of alkali metals are given. Please go through it. Very simple uses are given, and this is the end of group 1, little bit few part is there that we will see in next video. Thank you.